Hello, fellow YouTubers. How's everything going? It's been a crazy hot minute since I recorded a video, but I thought this video would be kind of cool and kind of helpful if anyone is going to the remaining tour dates of the Vans Warped Tour. Now, I wanted to explain some things first on my behalf, because I feel as though this is very important. I bought everything that you're going to see with my money, either that or I got it for free because they give out free stuff, you play games, you win a free prize, whatever, whatever. But personally, all the shirts that I bought with my own money, I'm so proud, I'm so glad I went. It was a crazy kick-ass last show, and if I could, I'd do it all over again. Despite the fact that my ankle's about to freaking snap in half. So, the three bands that I mainly went to go see were Bowling for Soup, Simple Plan, and Motionless in White. Now, due to the fact of some things that had happened, I was not able to see Simple Plan set. But, there is a but. The reason why I wasn't able to see their set was because they were the last ones on, and my dad went with me for a final tour because he likes Bowling for Soup and he likes Simple Plan. But because we weren't able to see them, that's okay because I have something else in store for you. I met them. It took 12 years for me to realize how bad I wanted this. And I didn't know they were even going to be at the Warped Tour until the lineup was announced in March. So people are going to be like, Sarah, why didn't you see their set? Well, the thing is, on the date that I went, it was a Sunday. And my dad went with me, and obviously my dad worked. He works. I work too. I work evenings. He works the day shift where he works. So after I saw Motionless and White, I really wanted to see Simple Plan, but I was like, you know what? I love Simple Plan. I grew up listening to them. They were the shit. They were the shit in the early 2000s. They've changed a lot. They've grown a lot. They married. They got kids. They're awesome. But the thing is, I realized that day went perfect. I met them, and that's all I needed. I didn't need to see them play. I physically met them. I have pictures. I can't show you because it's on my phone, and I record with my phone. But I met them, I got their signature from a 25-year-old girl who has an emo kid inside of her. That was the shit. And the date I went was July 15th in Hartford, Connecticut. And let me tell you something, I would do it all over again. Like I said, if I had to choose between to meet them or see them play, I would choose to meet them. And that was awesome. Now, let's get into the merch factor. And what I'm thinking is we're going to start with each band at a time. Just feel as though that works. Now, believe it or not, the two bands I wanted to see, well, three included, but the top two I really wanted to see was Simple Plan and Bowling for Soup, and I was able to do that. However, I did want to see Motionless in White too. I saw them with Escape the Fate in 2011 when I was 18 and a senior in high school, but at the time, I didn't know who they were. I was there for Escape the Fate at the time, but you know what's funny? I saw them before I even knew them, and I got to see them again, so it works out. So I'm going to show you the Bowling for Soup stuff that I got first, just because I think that would make sense. So the first thing I got from the Vans Warped Tour, and this was the shirt I wore all day, so excuse me if it's wrinkly or it looks dirty, because it is. Was this cool dye one. It says Bowling for Freaking Soup on it. And believe it or not, I love the shirt. I'm not really into colors, but this one was a must. I actually saw a post from a week or so back of Bowling for Soup when they were at another Warped Tour location, and it showed their merch stuff, and I saw this in the picture, and I was like, I need this shirt. So therefore, I bought the shirt. So there's that shirt. The second shirt I bought was the one I'm currently wearing, and it says, I came I came for Bowling for Soup. And again, it's blue, it's a color, it's a little bit out of my comfort zone, but you know what? I thought, okay, why not? It's blue, Bowling for Soup, I like it, it's good. So, there's these two. Then, the other one I got, if I can find it for you, is this one. And you know, it just has a little skull on it. It says BFS. And then the back it says the same thing. Bowling for freaking soup. And this is also my favorite because, you know, you can't go wrong with a Bowling for Soup shirt, like, ever. You really can't. So then, so all three shirts together were, well, all three shirts were sold to me separately from each other. And each shirt was about $25. So, $25, $50, $75. So I spent $75 alone on Bowling for Soup shirts. The next thing I got for a Bowling for Soup thing were these stickers. And it was two for a dollar. So obviously, I'm not going to go wrong. This one has pizza on it. It says Bowling for Soup and has pizza. And then this one has a cute little skull. It says Bowling for Freaking Soup. It is backwards. I am sorry. But that's the way I have to show you. So Bowling for Soup, it was two for a dollar on the stickers. I don't know what I'm going to use for them yet, but I thought that was cool. Now, when I bought this last thing, it was plain. But my dad met Bowling for Soup, and I said to him, if you meet them, can you have them sign this for me, and I'll get it framed. So the poster itself was a dollar, and I thought this was really cool that they signed this for me. And it has three of the signatures on it, because unfortunately this guy right here was not on the tour and they had a fill-in for him. But that is okay, because it's a good time, and you know, it was awesome. And you know what? It's Bowling for Freaking Soup. So this was a dollar, and then they signed it. Yeah. I think I'm going to get this framed. I think this is important enough to get framed. So there you go for that. So that's the Bowling for Soup stuff I got. The next band we're going to do is probably Simple Plan. And the reason for that is because I grew up listening to them, you know. Their first album came out, I think, in 2002. I'm trying to think. 93, 94, 95, 98, 99, 2000, 01, 02, 03, 04. I think I was 12 when I started listening to them, so I'm trying to think. So I think it was like around 05 or 06. It could have even been 2007 that I started listening to Simple Plan. And the thing is, with Simple Plan is, you know, I loved their sound. I loved how they expressed themselves through their music at the time. I'm going to be honest, though. I don't like their new stuff. I mean, the most I'll listen up to is their album. I think it's a self-titled. It's, I don't know if it's a self-titled album or if it's whatever, but it's all of them on the front and they're shooting out, like, champagne from a bottle. That's the most recent album I'm going to listen to of theirs. I personally like how they were in the early 2000s. I grew up with that. That's what my opinion is, and I'm sticking with it. And like I said, I met them. It was an awesome thing. So the way that this meet and greet worked is you had to buy something, and that's usually how that shit works. So, and then when you went back to wait, you showed them what you bought, and that was counted as your ticket to meet them. So this is the shirt I bought. It just has an SP in the front. And then if you turn it to the back, it has Simple Plan on the back. And I like this. This reminds me of their rather emo days when their No Pads, No Helmets, Just Balls album came out in like 2002, I think. I can be wrong. And when their Untitled album came out, which also was another favorite album of mine. And then this one I got, and I thought this was rather important because this one's really important. And the other thing is, when I was like in that awkward middle school, high school phase, I had a shirt that I bought from Hot Topic. It said Simple Plan, it had all of them on it. And unfortunately, I wore the crap out of that shirt. And it got holes in it, and I could not wear it anymore. So I even tried sewing one of the holes, and it just wasn't going to work. So I had to toss it out. I had another shirt that I got from Hot Topic, and it had SP, and it was in bright colors. And it said the entire lyrics to the Untitled song at the end of the album of their Untitled album. But however, that shirt got the crap worn out of it, and I had to throw it out as well. So this shirt that I bought says Simple Plan, and it says, still just a pop punk kid. And this is actually pretty pop. This is pretty realistic, especially for them, because, you know, like I said, when they got first discovered, they were in the pop emo punk scene, along with Avril Lavigne when she first started out. But that was the two shirts, and then here's the poster that they signed for me, which I have to figure out what I'm going to do with it. I think I'm going to hang it up on my wall. But this is the poster, and you can see there are some signatures right there, right there, right there, right there. So this is the poster that they signed for me. And again, I was very sad to know that David DeRozas was not going to be on the tour, but I'm glad that he is, for the reason why he's not on the tour, he's actually helping himself out and he's bettering himself as an individual. So I'm really happy about that. Next thing, and to be honest with you, I think this was actually one of my most favorite parts of the day, and I actually have a story for you, is with this band right here, Motionless in White. Now, again, as I mentioned earlier in the video, I happened to see them before I even knew who they were, which I thought was freaking hilarious, because go back 7 years ago, give or take, it was 2011. So give or take about 2011, it was the winter time. So I think it was like February or March. It was freezing out. I just know that. It was for a birthday gift. My mom got me concert tickets to see Escape the Fate in concert at the Webster Theater. And I went with my friend at the time. And what happened was, it was a band who I did not know about. Motionless in White and Escape the Fate was the headliner. Which, by the way, I still love Escape the Fate, just gonna be honest. But I think this band's pretty cool too, and I'm in love with Black Bolt Brides. So I thought that was funny that they opened for Escape the Fate back then, and I thought it was funny that I was actually going to see them this time around too, and I actually picked up some of their stuff, and I freaking love it. So the first thing I got was this poster, just a small poster with the four of them on there. Now the thing is, I don't know too much about the band's names. I just know like the singer's name. So please bear with me. If you know the names better than I do, please let me know what they are. There was a guy named Ghost. That was his nickname. I don't know his full name. He was the bassist of the band, and this was recently. So I think he had to leave the band for personal reasons. I'm not too sure. So I do know when I saw them, TJ Bell, who was a former member of Motionless, who is now a member of Escape the Fate, was helping Motionless and White out for the tour with the bass. So that's why there's only four of them in the picture. Because TJ Bell was helping them out, even though he was a former member of Motionless and now he's a current member of Escape the Fate, he was helping them out, helping Motionless out with the tour. So right now, currently, there's only four current members. That's the singer, and I know it's hard to see. I think he's a guitarist. I think he's the drummer, and I think he's another guitarist. Sorry, so singer, guitarist, drummer, other guitarist. Again, I don't know their names, so please comment if you know what their names are, except for the singers, because I already know his name. Now, I think this is kind of cool, because this actually is kind of like my type of style, and I think I'm actually going to wear this tomorrow. So I think this is kind of cool. This was the first shirt I saw that I had to have of theirs. And I can wear it to the gym, or I could just wear it around. And it says, "Fear is not my fate." Motionless and white with their name in the bottom. And it's in a coffin. Now, anyone who knows me knows I love black, knows I love purple, and knows I like coffins. And it's just part of the goth thing, you know. It's just part of the goth attire, you know. We're gonna haunt, love the goth things. Yeah. So what's funny was, I didn't think I was gonna order another, or I didn't think I was gonna get another shirt. I was like, okay, I'm good. Whatever, whatever. So I waited the entire day. I waited for their set. They played. It was awesome. And I was like, I want another shirt. Now the thing is, when I got this shirt, I saw another shirt that I wanted, but I wasn't sure if I like really wanted it or not. But then after I saw this, I'm like, okay, I really want this shirt. So I picked this shirt up too. It's black with purple tie-dye at the bottom. And I think it's really cool because it has a mummy on it. So here you go. It's black and then goes to purple tie-dye and has a mummy on it. It says motionless and white, and then it has the motionless and white logo on the bottom. And I think this is kind of cool. I know I'm going to probably wear this a lot. I'm going to probably wear the other one a lot too. And I think that's just freaking awesome, you know? It was the final tour. You can't go wrong with the final tour and having a good time. And like I said, this was the second time in Warped Tour that I've met someone. I met New Year's Day last year, which is another story for another video. Kick-ass band. Can't wait to see him in August with In This Moment. Have not seen In This Moment yet. So I'm super excited to see them August 2nd with my cousin and Mohegan Sun. But to come forth, because I think this story should sum up my experience with Motionless and White for a second time, knowing actually who they were as a band this time. So I had a friend who was also going to Warped Tour, and we were going to meet up and go to Motionless and White set together. Now, the thing was, I got a schedule, because you could buy a schedule for like $5 or $2 or whatever, so you can know who's playing at what time. It was a toughy thing, because Bowling for Soup was on, I think, like around, Simple Plan's meet and greet was at 4. So Simple Plan's meet and greet was at 4. Bowling for Soup was on, I think, at 5 to 5:25. Motionless was on at freaking 5:30. So I had to book it from the main stage to the Bowling for Soup tent, because my dad was going to meet Bowling for Soup for me. And then I had to book it from the Bowling for Soup tent to the Monster White Lightning stage. So I did that. We left a couple songs early in Bowling for Soup set, because they sang Stacy's Mom by Fountains of Wayne. They sang 1985. They sang High School Never Ends and Girl All the Bad Guys Wants. Can't go wrong with that. So my dad and I left a little bit early so I can get into that, to the Bowling for Soup tent, so we can meet them. And then I got a water and I booked it to the stage. So by the time I got to the stage, the crowd was already kind of there. So I could not find my friend. So turns out she made it up to the front, and I'm so happy for her that she did. I was in the back, and what happened was, I'm pushing my way through a bunch of hot, sweaty people in like 90 degree weather. It's freaking hot. I'm fucking sweating. I'm sweating rainbows, okay? Because of my Bowling for Soup shirt that's tie-dye. I'm like sweating rainbow in a crowd full of black. So that's why I'm like, it sounds kind of weird that I love Bowling for Soup and I love Motionless, but whatever. So I'm in the crowd. We're waiting for them to come on. They start to come on and they sing the first song. I don't know what the first song was. I don't know. It was from an older album, I think, so I'm not really sure. And all of a sudden, boom, a circle mosh pit happens. Now, I've never moshed in my life. I've been part of mosh pits, but I've stayed away from them. I've never been like actually like involved, or I have gotten hurt by one before. At that concert in 2011, I escaped the fame. I got slammed into a fucking wall because people are fucking idiots. So I'm in the dead center of a circle mosh pit. And I mean, there are people running around me. I have a heavy backpack on with all my shit on. I have all these idiots just running around me. I'm like dead set in the middle of the circle mosh pit, and I have to book it to the closest exit. Now, obviously, I still want to see their set, obviously, but I had to get to a safe place first. So I book it to the end of the circle where the crowd is part of the crowd again. So I freaking booked it, and then the circle mosh pit grows a little bit bigger. See, the thing is, I don't really consider moshing a good time. That's just my own personal. I like to enjoy the music. I like to just stand there and listen. I feel as though, and this is just my own personal opinion, you could have a completely different one. It's okay. Personally, I've seen people get trampled. I've seen people get bloody noses. I've seen people get punched in the face. I've seen people get kicked on, stomped on, their phones get ruined. Concussions. I've seen people get really hurt. That's the main point. And it's just not my thing. I go to a concert, I want to enjoy it, I don't want to die. So I book it to the back. I'm in the back, and it grows bigger, so I have to go even further back. As I'm trying to wiggle my way through the back, I get hit. And what I mean is that when I get hit with my friend who's crouching, and his butt got in my face and hit my face. So now I'm standing up straight, and I got hit in the face with someone's ass who I know. So now my head is between someone's butt and someone's stomach, and I'm bent over like that. So I try to pull myself up, and I'm just trying to see the motionless and white set up. And I was glad I stayed. I was glad I didn't book it. I was glad I didn't leave, because, you know, that was a band who I really wanted to see, actually. And I'm glad I got to saw them, and I'm glad I got their stuff. And I'm going to be honest, I think TJ Bell is hot, and I wanted to see him. And the thing is, I haven't seen him with Escape the Fate. I haven't seen Escape the Fate in a really long time in show. So I thought, well, it works both ways, because I want to see how they perform since I've seen them last, and I want to see TJ Bell too on bass. And damn, he was hot. Just saying, I couldn't stop staring at him, like, he was so cute. I was like, oh damn, you cute boy. So overall, I almost got killed in a mosh pit. My friend's ass got in my face because he was trying to crowd surf. Thanks, Scott Jenkins. Love you for putting your butthole in my face. And I was sweaty. And the other good thing that I thought about was there was this guy who was next to me, and he was really, really nice because, you know, he knew, like, this was my second time seeing them. And he's like, oh, don't worry, you'll be fine. Just do what you gotta do. So because I'm 5'4", so I'm not very tall. I'm like in the short, medium area. I couldn't really take a picture. So I asked him nicely. I was like, hey, you're a little bit taller than me. Could you possibly take a picture? Because I can't take one. He was like, yeah, that's fine. Don't worry about it. So I gave him my phone. He zooms in, he takes a picture of Chris Motionless for me on my phone. So now I have a picture of him. And I said, thank you very much. I'm Sarah. And he introduced himself. He was Nick. I didn't get any other information after that. He was kind of cute, too. I'm not going to lie. He was kind of cute. And he was just having a good time. He was just like, hey, I'm here to have a good time, you know? So overall, even though my ankles felt like they were going to snap, I got caught dead center in a circle mosh pit. My friend's ass hit me in the face. And I got so fucking sweaty. And I so fucking nasty, and I got serious chub rub walking back to the damn car. And this day that my ankles are still killing me, I do it all over again. This was probably one of the best Warped Tours I've ever went to. And there's like, I've been to five of them. So, been to about five of them. So I want to say this one was good. Last year's was good. And my very first Warped Tour that I actually was like so stoked to go to was 2013. And the reason for that was because it was the first time ever I saw Black Veil Brides perform. And I was going through a pretty crappy time at that time period too with an ex of mine. So overall, that was my Warped Tour haul. It's interesting to know how many bands you can see at one point. And like I said, with Simple Plan, I would do it all over again. You know, I wanted to actually meet the masterminds behind it. If I had to do it again, I would, the same way. I wouldn't see the set, I'd meet them. It's more of a connection level, for me at least, because, like I said, I grew up listening to the music. I was bullied really hard in school, and I really listened to them, and I loved how they sounded. And I'd do it all over again. With Bowling for Soup, I'd do it all over again. Emotionless is why I do it all over again. With Simple Plan, I would do it all over again. And I'm so glad I have these memories, and I have pictures on my phone. I show them to people, and they're so happy, and it's like amazing. And you know, Warped Tour, Warped Forever, hashtag Warped Forever. Now, I hope you like this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know if you're going to a Warped Tour in the future before it ends. And if you are, who are you going to see? Again, let me know in the comments. Like, comment, subscribe. I hope you have a good one. And before I click out of this video, I'm thinking about creating a name for my subscribers and me. Let me know what you think, because I have a couple ideas. I really like the Creeps for like our little family, for like a little YouTube family, the Creeps. I think that's cool. I think the Owls, because I really like Owls, so either the Creeps or the Owls. I prefer the Creeps because I think that sounds a lot better. That's just me. But yes, let me know what you think. If you have any ideas as to what you want to be called, let me know. And I hope you like this video. I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.